Good morning students. So in the last video we have learned about the functions, user defined functions. Okay, so we have started the function concept in Python. So there are four types of functions in Python. So what are all they? How many types of functions? Four types of functions. So user defined function, built in function, recursive function and lambda function. Okay, so in the last video we have learned the user defined function. So how will you create a user defined function? So what keyword must be used? So we will be using the keyword definition, that is def. So first we have to start the function with the keyword def, and then we will be giving our function name. Okay, so function name we will be giving, and then bracket, if you want we can give parameter, and then your statements, and then the return statement. So in return also, if you want you can give the value, otherwise you need not. Okay, so this is the syntax for the function, that is user defined function. So def, function name, parameter, and your statements, and your, and is the return statement. Okay, so in the parameter, when you are seen, we can give what type of parameter can be given. Okay, so there are four types of arguments. Okay, four types of arguments we can give. So what are all they? Okay, so first one, required argument. Second one, keyword argument. Third one, default. And the fourth one, variable length. Okay, so this is the four types of arguments or parameters. Okay, so required, keyword, default and variable length parameters. Okay, so we can see how we are using it. So if you want we can give parameters, otherwise we need not, that we have seen in the user defined function. Okay, if you are giving the parameter, then how these types of parameters can be used. Okay, so first one, required argument, that is if you are giving the function definition has the parameter. So if it has more than one parameter or two parameter, then the order, in which order we are giving the parameter, in the same order we should give the, in the function call we have to give the values. Okay, so when we are giving the function, when we, after that we will be calling the function. How we will be calling the function? Just give using the function name, and then we will be giving the parameters, isn't it? So if you are giving that case, in required argument we have to give the values to the parameter in the correct order. Okay, in the specified order only you should give the required argument. Okay, suppose if you are having, I'm having a function area. Okay, definition area, width comma height, and I'm asking it to return w star h. Okay, so next I'm calling the function, so area, and I'm giving 5 comma 7. Here width and height has the, just has a numerical values, so they can give 5 and 7. Suppose I'm having width is equal to 5 and height is equal to 7, I will be giving the values like this. Okay, suppose I'm having width is equal to 8 and height is equal to 7. Okay, I want this, but when I change and give width is equal to 8 comma 7, means it will be, it will not affect, because here thus we are giving the numeric values. Okay, so in the same way, if you are giving the another value, first string values we are giving. Okay, suppose I am having the, so let us see an example. So definition, print value, and here I am giving a string 1. Print example 1 and then I am giving print string 1. Okay, return. And then I am calling the function. So this is print val. And I have to give one parameter. I am giving as welcome. Let it be. Okay. So this is the definition. This is the function name. And I have given one parameter. And print example 1, print str1, return I have given. And then I have called the function print val. Okay. So what will be the output for it? So when I am calling the function, this welcome will be passed out a string 1. So example 1 and then string 1 welcome will be printed. Okay, so this will be the output. That is, the corresponding string must be, the value must be passed to the required argument. Okay, so the same thing, if I am not giving this welcome, suppose I am not giving this word welcome. Just I am calling the function without parameter, then what will be the output for me? So the output will be error. Okay, that's so there will be an error because it has a parameter 1 but I have not given any value. Okay, so that is required argument is, if how many arguments are there, we have to specify that much value in the function calling. When we are calling the function and the how many parameter does the function has, we have to give the required values to the, when we are calling the function, that is the required argument. Okay, so next we are going to see the keyword argument. So what do you mean by keyword argument? Okay, suppose I am having here name and age. So I am having two parameters, okay, name and age. And here I can give, when I am calling the function print value, I am going to call the function print value. Consider this as example 2 or 1, let it be. So print val, now I have to give two values, name and age. So if I am giving in the inside the double quotes comma age. Okay, so I have defined a function print value. Here I am having two arguments. I am specifying two arguments, name and age, and print example 2. And here I have going to print comma name, and here print age. And then I am giving here the return. Okay, so consider this the function, and the function calling I have given Anu and 17. So here name is first name and second one age. So first I have given the name and the second I have given the value for the age. So it will directly take as it. In keyword argument, suppose if I want to give the values in the not in an order of the argument, we can give using the parameter name. Okay, so how we can give is, so print val in function calling, I can give age is equal to 17 comma name is equal to Anu. Okay, so here first I am having the argument name and second I am having the argument age, but I can give the values in the not in the same order, I can give in a different order. So different order means I have to specify the parameter name also. By giving the parameter name only we can give the values, that is called the keyword argument. That is, we are giving the parameter name, that is the keyword parameter name, and then its corresponding value. So that though we are not giving in the particular order and has been specified in the function definition, it will take the values correctly as we are giving the parameter name. Okay, so suppose I am having another one as group and I am giving another value also, I can give in the another order. So what will be the output for this? So print example 2 and then name Anu and then age 17. So this will be my output. Okay. So in required argument you have to give the corresponding values in the same order as you have specified in the function definition. But in the keyword argument, you no need to give in the same order. If you want, you can give in the same order. Otherwise, you may change the order of the values in function calling. When you are specifying like that, you have to specify the parameter name also. So this is the concept of keyword argument. Most probably we will be using the required argument concept only. So we will be giving the values as per the order in the function definition. So if you want, you can also change like this. So that is the keyword argument. Suppose I am having another parameter like this, okay, group. So this is my example 3, let me have. So again I have to print group comma group, okay, then return and then I am calling the function, that is print value. Now I have to give three values, name, age and group, but if I want I can give in the same order. Otherwise I can use the keyword argument, that is first I can give group is equal to first comma, I can give my name and third I am giving my age. Okay, so up to this, this is the program concept. So definition, print value, I am having the same function name with three parameters. Okay, so name, age and group, and I am going to print the three values. And then in the when calling the function, I have given the values for three parameters, but I have not given in the same order. First I am having here name, but I have given here in the second point, and then group is the third one, but I am here, so I have collapsed and give, that is I have not given in the same order. Okay, so that's why I have to specify the parameter name. So for which parameter this value belong to. Okay, so now what will be the output of this? So first example 3 and then name example 3, name, what is the name I have given? I have given the name as Anu and then I have given the age. What value I have given for age? For age I have given as 17 and then the group, that is group first. So this will be my output. Okay, so keyword argument means if you want you can give in the same order. Otherwise if you are giving the values for the parameter, we can use the parameter name and you can give the values. So as you are using the parameter name, we can change the order while giving the values in the function calling. Clear? So next, the third one is the default argument. So what do you mean by default value? So if you are not specifying any particular value, if you are given any value, it will be automatically taking that. So that is one is the default value, we will be saving default argument. So here also, so when you are giving the function definition and if you are having one or two parameters and if you are not giving the value for them, it will take the default value which has been specified in the function definition. Okay, in function definition if you are giving any default value and in the function calling if you are not giving any value for that particular parameter, the default value will be printed. Okay, so let us see an example. So definition, print value, let me have two parameter, name and salary, So I'm going to print example 4, print name is equal to command name, and then again I am printing the salary. So this is in the parameter sal. So return. Now I am calling the function print val, and I am going to give two values. Here I am having two parameters, so I have to give two values, Anu. And then suppose I am having this salary, okay. So if suppose I am giving like this, then what will be the output for me? For this my output will be error, because here it is having two arguments, but I have given only one value. So at that time I will be getting error. So yes, the sufficient data is not given. Okay. Suppose I have given this argument, that is parameter, as default one. Okay. So I am having two parameters, name or two arguments, name and salary. So salary I have given 50,000. So if I am not giving any values in the function calling, so it will be the default value. So if you want to give any default value for a particular parameter, it should be mentioned in the function definition. Okay. So in the while defining the function itself, I have set the value 50,000 to the argument salary. So suppose now, if suppose I am now giving this function calling statement print value Anu. Now what will be the output for me? So if I have not given, we have seen that it will be an error. Now there are two parameters, but I have given only one. So in this case my output will be example 4, name is Anu and salary will be 50,000. Okay, as I have not given the value for the second parameter, it will automatically take the default value. It will see whether any default value has been specified for the parameter which has not get given the value in the function calling. In function calling I have not given any value for the parameter salary. So it will search whether there is a default value, and the default value will be printed here. Okay. Here I am giving in the function calling, instead of 50,000, if I am giving and any value as 60,000. Now what will be the output for me? So for default I have given the value as 50,000. Now in the function calling I have given the value as 60,000. Then what will be my output? My output will be 60,000. So if I have given any value in the function calling, that will be overlooked by the default value. If I have not specified any value in the function calling, only the default value will be taken. Otherwise, if I given any value in the function calling, that value will be printed. Clear? So this is the default argument. So if you are not specifying any value in the function calling, the default value will be taken. Next, we are going to see the variable length parameter. So next one, variable length argument. So what do you mean by variable length argument? Okay. So in when you are specifying the parameters or arguments, so you must be, suppose if you are giving only two parameters, okay. Suppose I am going to find the area and I have given the length and breadth, two values. Suppose I want to add another one parameter, height. Okay. So length and breadth I have given. If I want to add another one to this function definition, then what I have to do? Then again I have to go to the function definition and I have to add the particular argument to it, and then so it will be becoming a, I have to search where is the function. So it will be becoming a tedious process for me. So when if you don't know the particular arguments you are going to give, then at that time you can use the variable length argument pattern. Okay. So in the function calling you may come to decide how many arguments to be needed. For such cases, you can use variable length argument. Okay. So therefore, that it has a syntax. That is, when you are specifying the argument, you must be giving the star sign, and then you can give your arguments. So that is definition, your function name, and then star, and then your arguments, your statements, and then the return statement. Okay, so this will be the syntax for the variable length argument. So the important one is you have to specify the star sign inside the bracket. Okay, so for variable length means when you are calling the function, though we are having only two values and we are specifying more than two values, we can use the variable length arguments. Okay, so suppose I am the same example, I am having length and breadth, and I am, so print length into breadth, return, and when calling the function area, suppose I am giving 5, 10, 15. Suppose I want to find the length into breadth into height. At that time, if I am including a new value in the function calling, so at that time it will not be able to get the particular function. So what will be the output for me here? So it will be showing the error message, because here only two arguments, I have given three values. So instead of giving the three values here and making the function definition to add one thing, we can use the variable length argument. Okay, so let us see an example program for variable length argument. So example definition print value, so star numbers, so for n in numbers, print n return. Okay, so when I am calling the function print val 10, 20, and again I can call the function .30. Okay, so consider this function, the definition print value, here I have used star, so it can get any number of arguments. So for n in numbers, print n and return. So first I have called the function with two arguments, and then second I have called the function with three arguments. So what will be the output for me? First 10 and 20 will be printed, and again 10, 20 and 30. This is with two arguments and this is with three arguments. So if you are not able to count how many arguments a function will need, you can give the star symbol, and when function calling, you can give how many parameters if you want, you can give. So that is the main advantage of variable length argument. Okay, so today we have learnt about the four types of arguments. So first one is the required arguments. So the values must be given in the correct positional order. Okay, and the second one, keyword argument. So in the keyword argument, you have to specify the particular parameter name, so it we can give in any order. And the third one, default argument. In default argument, if you are specifying any default value in the function definition, and in the function calling, if you are not giving the value for it, the default value will be printed. And the last one, variable length. So in the variable length, if you want to change the argument you are passing in the function calling, so in the function definition you have to specify that it is a variable length argument with the star symbol. So clear? So this is the four types of arguments in Python. So I think you must be clear with this. Thank you, students.